Welcome back to Technical Solution YouTube channel. A survey by Value Plan Sweeper estimates that 0.21% of the people are reportedly upgrading to Windows 11, and some are on Windows 8 or Windows XP and even on Windows Vista right now. Moving on, we recently got the news that the AMD will increase their pricing for the graphics GPU by AIPs from December, and Gigabyte has already done it. But the pricing for the RX 6900 XT will remain the same, while all other 6800 XT, 6700 XT, 6600 XT are getting upwards of $50, $10 to $50 increase, up to 6%, 4%, and 3% increase compared to the previous gen, which totally is not good, as since the GPU market is still bad right now. But given the fact it's on eBay, then it's fine because it's not a big deal. But $50 increase is still too much. Moving on, AMD will release a new GPU which will be based on Zen 2 architecture, and it will have its iGPU disabled, and it will be called Rainier X. It is a very, it can be a 4100G or 4500G, but 4000G series, but it's in there to compete Alder Lake 12 Gen CPU. But without an integrated graphics, and the next gen CS variant as AM4 and Zen 3D cache will launch, and at the end of the QT or Q3 of the next year, the AM5 motherboards will be launched, which Rafael AM5, and it will support X670 motherboards, and it will support PCIe 5 and DDR5 RAM, which has been leaked. But since DDR5 RAM may be legally coming to the close because it's too much high right now, and in the middle of Q3, Intel will launch its 13th gen CPUs. Moving on, the Intel will deal with the naming scheme of A380 graphics, Intel Arc A380 and graphics for its upcoming GPUs. And also on top of that, it is a lower clock variant. It is just 2.45 GHz, 6 GB RAM, and it is supposed to be performing against 1650 Super. But we need some kind of computation in that segment because there's no computation in budget segment, and Intel is coming close to the launch. Like, share, and subscribe for more tech news, and I will see you in the next one. Peace out.